Good afternoon, students. I am Dr. Sujay Sarkar of Department of Zoology of Bangobashi Morning Call. There is another type of pollution in our world. This is called the very common pollution nowadays. It is called the marine pollution. Let's see the slide. Look, the marine pollution, all that what is carried by rivers ultimately ends up in the seas. On their way to sea, rivers receive huge amount of sewage, garbage, agricultural discharge, biocides, including heavy metals. These all are added to the sea. Besides this, discharge of oils and petroleum products and dumping of radionuclides waste into sea also cause a marine pollution. Huge quantity of plastic is being added to sea and oceans. In this picture, in the first slide, you see that how many types of the sea animals are affected due to our human man-made activities. Huge quantity of plastic is being added to sea and oceans. Over 50 million pound plastic packing material is being dumped in sea of commercial fleets, whereas over 300 million pound entering through the inland waterways in the America. Many marine birds ingest plastic that causes gastrointestinal disorder. The chemical principle in PCBs causes the more damage is thinning of the eggshell and tissue damage of egg. Radionuclide waste in sea includes strontium, cadmium. These are the pollutants in sea may become dispersed by turbulence and ocean currents or concentrated in the food chain. They may sediment at the bottom by process like adsorption, precipitation, and accumulation. Bioaccumulation in food chain may result into loss of species diversity. This is a very danger to our world. The pollution is Baltic Sea and along the coast of the Finland to place largely from sewage and effluents from food industry. The pollution effect brought changes in species diversity in the bottom fauna. There were seen distinct junction with extinct of pollution in clear or less polluted water, whereas rich species diversity, which tended to decrease with increasing pollution load. In heavily polluted areas, like macroscopic benthic animals were absent, but crinoid larva occurred at the bottom. The oceans cover about 71% of the Earth's surface. They play an important role in the chemical and biological balance of the life on the Earth. They are vital to our food security, commerce, and the transportation. But human activity has troubled the health of oceans. The habits of marine mammals and fish have been degraded severely with pollution, responsible for the mass deaths of fish, mammals, and corals. Organochloric pollutants, pesticides, polychlorinated biphenyls, and a range of other toxic pollutants accumulate within fishes, later moving up the food chain, and it causes a reproductive disorder. What is marine population? According, it is defined that the discharge of waste substances into the sea, resulting in harm to living resources, hazards to human health, hindrance to fishery, and impairment of quality for use of seawater. Marine pollution is associated with the changes in physical, chemical, and biological conditions of the seawater. So, what are the pollutant sources and their effects? The sewage, mainly the chief pollutants are sewage, pesticides, plastic, metallic waste, oil, sediment fumes by deep sea mining, heat, radioactive waste, and the deep dredge spoil. The sewage, it may be entering the sea by direct drainage from the inland towns and industry, keeping at sea from ships. Detrimental effects of sewage: eutrophication, deoxygenation, foul deposits, reduced salinity, infection, and the toxic residue. Next, pesticides. Pesticides are organically active chemicals which are used to killing the pest. May enter the ocean from the atmosphere after aerial spraying, from overland runoff of spread areas, from international dumping in the sea. Pesticides affect food chain directly. These are more and more concentrated in fish, seagulls, seals, penguins, and the marine plankton. PCBs have been found to have a serious effect on aquatic animals' reproductive cycle and known to cause patches on the skin, immunotoxicity, kidney damage, weight loss, and tumor formation in others. The plastic waste may mostly dangerous one type of pollutants. The mass of plastic in the ocean may be as high as 100 million metric tons. Many animals that live on the sea consume fruits sam by mistake, as it often looks similar to their natural prey. Plastic debris, when bulky or tangled, is difficult to pass and may become permanently lodged in the digestive tracts of these animals, blocking the passage of food and causing death through starvation or infection. Fishing nets entangle fish, dolphins, sea turtles, sharks, dugongs, crocodiles, seabirds, crabs, and other creatures, restricting movement, causing starvation and infection, and in those that need to return to the surface of breath and suffocation. Metallic waste, metallic chemical waste are released from the industry. Some industries, there's a nickel, arsenic, cadmium, it is deposited in the sea and it can harm the water, and it is consumed by such fishes. It will affect our nervous system, kidneys, because the bioaccumulation, if small fishes eat this, consume this metallic waste, and then the small fishes can be eaten by the large fishes, and large fishes eaten by the mammals or human beings also. So this is the bioaccumulation or biomagnification. It can be affect nervous system, kidneys, brains, respiratory system, or even it will lead us to death. Oil may be ever enter the seawater by number of ways as follows: cargo tankers, bilge pumping at sea, import of losses, import oil losses, collisions, import tanker accident, oil leakage from pipelines, blowout of wells, oil waste from oil fields, and oil spills mixed with the urban sewage. These are the source of the oil pollution. It mixed with the seawater. It is an oil stick, oil slick from a satellite stick, picture from the Mediterranean Sea. Oil can be affect the overall detrimental effect of pollution. It reduction the dissolved oxygen, it reduction the light penetration, its spilling causes lethal toxicity aquatic flora and fauna also. Smoothering course of oil have killed lichens and algae, although the shorelines, sea otter will die when the fur become saturated when oil is losing insulation. Waste from oil refiners and discharge petroleum from ships cause heavy damage to fishery. Hydrocarbons in oil get incorporated in body tissues of marine animals. When the concentration of crude oil rises to the sea water reaches 0.02 ppm parts per million, fish eggs being to hatch irregularly or late, while the development of already hatched young fish or larvae, crabs, and lobster become abnormal at oil concentration. When main consumer the fishes, the oil polluted seawater, it may result the breathing problems and damage liver and kidney. These are a picture of what type on aquatic birds. These are due to the oil sediments. The sediment plumes, the deep sea mining. Because of deep sea mining, the removing parts of the sea floor disturb the habit of the benthic organisms. Plumes are caused when the tailings from mining and dumped back into the ocean, creating a cloud of particles floating in the water. The heat accumulation of unstable heat from human activities can disrupt ecosystem and maintain environment. The power plants of the seawater for cooling, the water is generally returned to the sea temperature 11 to 22 degrees centigrade, which is higher than the was initially. One nuclear power plant may use as much as billion gallons of seawater per day. Marine life is extremely sensitive to changes in water temperature. Higher temperature can lead to premature spawning, fish migration, lack of oxygen, or death of marine life. Next, the radioactive waste. Radioactive materials enter to the oceans mainly from following ways: from natural background source, from fallout of nuclear weapons testing, from operation of nuclear reactors, through international or uninterrupted direct releases, mining and processing of ores to produce radioisotopes, emission from the industrial use of nuclear energy, leakage from underground nuclear detonations, from shipboard reactors, radioactive contaminant seawater will consumed by plants during photosynthesis, act as a medium for radioactivity on them. By this radionuclide enter into the food chain of marine water. When human being consume this radioactive fishes, it will cause cancer, leukemia, eye cataract, DNA breakage of and carcinoma in humans. Then the dredge spoils constitute the greatest pollutant input by volume of to the ocean. Spoils from the dredging or mining offshore minerals are deposited within a few miles offshore, where the potential impact is the greatest. Often they also contain sewage or industrial waste solids and solids from street runoff. Consequently, they often contain objectionable amount of hazardous chemicals, pathogens, oil, and may exert high oxygen demand on the surrounding environment. This can damage caused by the dredging of twofold, the occurring at the dredging site and the occurring at the dredge falls in disposal area. Then the human impacts on marine environment. So first of all, I already described in the water pollution, the first of all, the eutrophication. It increases the chemical nutrients, typically compounds containing nitrogen, phosphorus in an ecosystem. It can result in an increase the ecosystem primary productivity and further effects including lack of oxygen. The biggest culprit are rivers that empty into the ocean, and with it the many chemicals used as fertilizer in agriculture as well as the waste form livestock and human beings. An excess of oxygen depleting chemicals in the water can lead to hypoxia and the creation of the dead zone. So one type of the human impact of marine environment, the eutrophication, is caused the lack of oxygen, and that can affect the marine life. Then the acidification, another way of human made, the oceans and the normally the natural carbon sink absorbing carbon dioxide from the atmosphere, structure made calcium carbonate may become vulnerable or dissolution affecting corals and the ability of shellfish from the cells. Oceans and the coastal ecosystem have removed about 25% of the carbon dioxide emitted by human activities between 2000 to 2007, and about half the anthropogenic carbon dioxide is released since the start of the Industrial Revolution. So acidification, it can be harm the marine life also. The plastic debris also, we can say in the previous slide also, 80% of the marine debris is plastic. Next, the other toxins like the it is secreted from the industries and the agriculture field, the PCB, DDTs, or the furans, dioxins, phenols, and radioactive waste. It can harm the marine life. The noise pollution. The marine life can be marine life can be susceptible to noise or should pollution from source such as passing ships, oils, exploration, seismic surveys, and naval low frequency active sonar. Sound travels more rapidly and over larger distance in the sea than the atmosphere. Marine animals such as cetaceans often have weak eyesight and live in the world largely defined by the aquatic information. This applies also to many deeper sea fish who live in the world of darkness. Between 1950 to 1975, ambient noise in the ocean increased by about 10 decibels. That is a tenfold increase. Noise also makes species communicate louder, which is called the Lombard vocal response. Then the mitigation, either the human population is reduced, a way of found to reduce the ecological footprint left behind by the average human. The second way is for humans, individually by pollutants, that requires social and political will, the most important strategy for reducing marine pollution is education, awareness, research, and dissemination. Then how could we control the marine pollution? Stabilization of the ecosystem, reutilization, recycling, and 3Rs, renovations, and recharge of the waste. Removal of the pollutants to control oil pollution following methods by use skimming, biodegradation, burning, using a suitable absorbing material. It can be removed from condenser cooling waters prior to their disposal into the marine water. Removal of the phosphorus by electrolysis, adapting the appropriate methods for remove heavy metals and the marine water from the marine water. Radioactive waste can be removed by reduced by the ion exchange techniques, precipitation, and radionuclides. The impacts of deep sea mining can be minimized or reduced by using proper mining technique, creating awareness on marine pollution, local communities near sea must protect sea, management by government, incentive must be offered by for conservation. Industrial units should be equipped with pollution control instruments. And last, the conclusion, oceans over the Earth's surface, about 71%, and play an important role in the chemical and biological balance of life on the Earth. These are rich with marine resources like minerals, oil, and marine life, and the seafood supplies meet a substantial food requirement of the world's population. If the marine life is affected by the pollution and if they carry the pollutants in its biomass, the human population may get the impact while consuming such resources. Hence, it is necessary for aware about the marine pollution and to protect the marine water from the pollutants. So necessary to prevent and control this pollution. So let us save our oceans and the huge marine ecosystem. These are the references where I made the slides, and thank you for your patience. Thank you. We're all about the types of pollution in the unit 5, in the theory syllabus of unit 5, and there are two classes are required for your completion of the subject, completion of this course unit 5. Okay. Thank you.